Let us talk about refraction through a glass prism. What is glass prism? It is a refractive media which consists of two rectangular and three rectangular surfaces. Let's assume ABC is a glass prism. OP is incident ray. This is normal N1, and this ray reflects inside the glass. Drop normal here also, say N2, and finally the ray comes out in air. This is called emergent angle. This is R and S. I can define this angle as I. This is R1. This is R2. If I extend this incident ray in forward direction and emergent ray in backward direction, wherever they intersect, this angle is termed as angle of deviation. So what is angle of deviation? First thing, angle of deviation. It is an angle by which incident ray deviates from its actual path after passing through a glass prism. It is termed as passing through a glass prism. That's all. So let's find out formula for calculating refractive index of the material of this prism. How do we calculate? Have a look. In quadrilateral, A, P, N, R. Sum of opposite sides of the angles are equal to 180. So angle A plus angle N is equal to 180 degree. In triangle PNR, sum of all interior angles is equal to 180. This is another property of geometry. Comparing equation 1 and 2, from equation 1 and 2, we can conclude angle A is equal to R1 plus R2. This is equation 3. Is that clear? Now, angle of deviation delta . If we look it closely, it is an exterior angle of triangle. I can mark this as Q, point Q, QPR. So this delta is equal to sum of angle 1 plus angle 2, that is angle 1 plus angle 2. Angle 1 we can write it as I minus R1. Angle 2 I can write it as plus E minus R2. This you can put it as I plus E minus in the bracket R1 plus R2. Now R1 plus R2 is equal to A. So therefore delta is equal to I plus E minus A, and that you can say I plus E equals to A plus delta, equation 5. For minimum angle of deviation, minimum angle. Your condition is I should be equal to R, and when I becomes equal to R, R1 automatically becomes equal to R2. And I assume R1 equals to R2 equals to R. Let. Then from equation 5. From equation 5. 2I is equal to A plus delta M. And this implies I is equal to A plus delta M by 2. And from equation 3, visible A plus R1 plus R2, from equation 3 you will have R plus R is equal to A. This is R is equal to A by 2. Substituting in Snell's law. What you will get? Mu air to glass is equal to sin I over sin R. This you can say equation 7. When you put these values, you will get A mu g is equal to sin A plus delta M by 2 over sin A by 2. If we plot a graph between angle of incidence and angle of deviation, it comes out parabolic, and the lowest point of this graph corresponds to minimum angle of deviation and corresponding angle of incidence. So you can even plot the graph and calculate minimum angle of deviation. Angle of prism normally provided in the laboratories at your level is 60 degree, because these are equilateral triangle based prism. So you can calculate refractive index of glass or any other transparent liquid by using hollow prism. So this you can take it as your project also. Now we will see relation between delta and refractive index. As we know, mu ag is equal to sin a plus delta by 2 over sin a by 2. For small angles, theta tends to 0. This trigonometrical identity says sin theta is theta. Then a mu g is equal to a plus delta by 2 over a by 2. A by 2 as you can say, you will obtain delta is equal to a mu g minus 1 into A. This will be the relation between deviation, angle of deviation and angle of prism A along with refractive index. This is the question asked in the board examination this year, 2020. Calculate angle of emergence E of the ray of light incident normally on a plane. Refractive index of the glass is given. Pehla case hai. In second case, this says if it emerges out in water instead of air, तब एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस की वैल्यू क्या होगी. बहुत सिंपल क्वेश्चन था. आई डोंट नो व्हाई पीपल आर अफ्रेड ऑफ. दिस इज गिवन 60 डिग्री, दिस इज 90 डिग्री, सो दिस इज 30 डिग्री. दिस एंगल इज 90, सो दिस इज 60. दिस इज नॉर्मल ड्रॉन, सो दिस इज 30. यू हैव एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस एज 30. सो यूज स्नैप्स लॉ. साइन आई ओवर साइन आर इज इक्वल टू म्यू. When you apply here, then it is sin 30 over sin E is equal to root 3. Then sin 30, we know it is 1 by 2. So you will have 1 by 2 sin E is equal to root 3. This implies sin E is equal to root 3 by 2. So E is equal to sin inverse root 3 by 2, that is 60 degree. Second part is little more interesting. Again we have to use same formula. This one, but difference will be here you will have glass to water, right? There you have glass to air, fine. When you talk about glass to water, it is mu w over mu g dividing and multiplying by mu a, that is mu a over mu g, right? So you will have answer here mu a mu w divided by a mu g. Right? Now both the refractive index are given. So it is angle is again 30. This is sin E. Water is 4 by 3 and this is given root 3. So when you solve, it is 1 over 2 sin E is equal to 4 over 3 root 3, or you can call it as 3 E is equal to 3 root 3 over 8. So E is equal to sin inverse 3 root 3 over 8. Now this angle, if you look at, need your table. If you don't have table, you can leave answer even here, that doesn't matter. But angle of deviation, will it increase or decrease? So check the value of sin inverse 3, it is 7.73, so it is 5.2 divided by 8, and this will be nearly 0.6, 0.7, and here it was root 3. For the first case, it was root 3 by 2, that is 0.8. So here angle value is decreasing while it is going in water. Let us talk about now dispersion of light. What is dispersion of light? It is the phenomenon of splitting of white light into its 7 constituent colors on passing through a glass prism. So when this white beam is passing through a glass prism, it gets splitted into 7 colors, and these 7 colors are vibrio. Everybody knows about it. Right? The pattern so obtained on the screen is termed as a spectrum of white light. Now question arises, why does white light get dispersed? Why does white light get dispersed? So we have answer here. According to Cauchy's relation, Cauchy is very known mathematician. According to Cauchy's relation, refractive index mu of the medium can be related with the wavelength by this relation, where ABC are constant. So basically, refractive index is going reciprocal to the wavelength. And as we know, wavelength of red color is maximum and violet color is minimum. So when white light passes through the glass prism, the same material glass, violet color will observe maximum refractive index and red color will observe minimum refractive index. Rest of the color observe refractive index in between these two values. These are two extremums, minimum and maximum values. Now we know relation delta is equal to mu minus 1 into A. Since mu B is greater than mu R, this implies delta V is greater than delta R. So violet color will deviate maximum, that's why violet color in the spectrum will appear down to the screen and that color is appearing at the top of the screen. That's how white light gets dispersed. There are two terms which we have to remember. Number one, angular dispersion. Angular dispersion for a given prism is defined as the difference in angle of deviation of two extremum colors, or two extreme colors. Which are two extreme colors? Number one is violet is maximum deviation, red is minimum, so delta V minus delta R. Use this relation and form equation for violet and red, then you will have, you can write mu V minus 1 into A minus mu R minus 1 into A, and finally you obtain an expression mu V mu R into A. This is angular dispersion. There is another term for prism you can define, and this is termed as dispersive power. Dispersive power, it is defined as the ratio of angular dispersion to the mean deviation. Mean deviation is means we are counting yellow color as a mean color in the spectrum of white light, because it has got exactly mid wavelength. Actual spread is from 3000 to 7000. So the average comes out 4000 to 3000. Average comes out 5500, and yellow color has got 5500 as the wavelength. So you will have delta V minus delta R over delta Y. You can write mu V minus mu R into A over mu Y minus 1 into A. A gets cancelled. So you got expression mu V mu Y minus 1. This will be formula for angular dispersion. I am rubbing the lower test so that you can note it down even. No problem.